The TCPA took a step back in time last week as it opened its doors and archives for an evening celebrating planning's radical, idealistic roots. The organisation's founder, Ebenezer Howard, gazed down on an evening that included poetry and live music with renditions of songs by Bob Dylan and Bruce Springsteen. I spoke to TCPA chief planner Hugh Ellis before the event to find out what the idea behind the evening was.
And the idea, I suppose, came from two things. One, that planning's having a pretty tough time. So we've been looking back at sort of the early founds of the planning movement. And secondly, from some of a project our young planners are doing at TCPA, which is in the coalfield. And what we found was that in the area we were looking at was actually an area where some of the first inspirational kind of planners came from, which was from the North Derbyshire coalfield. And then we just hit on the very rich scene of radical thinkers. And I think there's a couple of generations of people who have no idea that these people exist, or who they were, or what they were saying. And actually, when you drill into it, you find this incredible kind of rich background to what we do. And so the idea of the event really is to try and bring some of that out, expose a new generation of people to it.
So what can these, I mean, some of them are quite radical thinkers, Kropotkin, Ebenezer Howard. What can modern planners learn from them and then take from their writings?
I mean, I think it's the biggest lesson of all, really, which is that planning has become very bureaucratic and planners' reputation has kind of fallen. But the origins of planning are high ideals. You know, it's about equality, it's about fantastic housing for working people, it's about redistribution, it's about control over land. These ideas really are the radical heart of it, and I think we have to rediscover a bit of that so that we know what we're doing, essentially. And in these times especially, I think having a sense of idealism about what we do is what we've lost. Planners are kicked around, morale's pretty low. But in these founding men and women at the beginning and the origin of the movement 100 years ago, they faced equal problems, but they had the will to kind of drive it through. So I think there's inspiration and there's also lessons. And the lesson is planning is about values, about politics, and we should remember that and relive those values, I think, particularly now.
Okay, you mentioned politics. So where does this fit into the localism agenda?
Well, it's interesting because, of course, people like Prince Kropotkin, who was very influential, was an anarchist and talked about local communities doing it for themselves, which would fit very well with the new localism agenda. But there is a really profound lesson, I think, which we've forgotten, which is that if you're really going to make it work for the communities at the toughest end of the social exclusion spectrum, the state has a role to play. You know, you have to enable people to act as well as simply saying, act. And there's a risk, I think, particularly in the north and particularly in some communities, that this localism agenda is more about abandonment and not about giving people real choice. And what the early pioneers of planning understood is that you need a combination of the two. This idea that, the state is all bad or the state is all good is the wrong argument. The state can be a great enabler, but at the same time, people can do it for themselves, mostly. And so we've a lot to learn from all of that. It's a shame we forgot it, I think.